Alright, so if you guys watched last video, I told you guys at the end of the video I had some big news. So Vegas Drift is holding an event here in Colorado August 23rd and 24th at Pikes Peak International Raceway. This event is a Pro 2 licensing shootout where the top three podium finishers receive a Pro 2 license and some pretty healthy sized cash prizes and things like that. I wanted to originally run the event in the truck, but unfortunately they follow Formula Drift rules, so the truck doesn't comply because it's body on frame. They want unibody vehicles and so on and so forth. So kind of just like let that event go, put it in the back of my mind, and then my buddy Avery kind of jokingly was like, hey, you could borrow my car, and I kind of just laughed it off. And then I told my wife Elizabeth about the event and how Avery offered me his car, and she kind of pushed me into it. She said, you should do it. You should absolutely go do that. It sounds like it'd be a fun event and good experience for you. So I signed up for the event, and Avery and I are going to prep his car for me to drive it at that event. And we scheduled some practice days for me to get comfortable in his car, and I'm really excited about it. This is probably the most serious drift event I've done. I mean, I've done a couple competitions, but this one's probably like the most serious, and the entrance fee to it was pretty fucking expensive too, so hopefully it's not a waste of time and money, but we'll see. Also, big news, this week I decided that there's no time like the present. I'm going to start working on my E36, my Pro-Am build. So I'm waiting for my friend Kyle to show up because the car is up in the other unit and I can't move it by myself, but I kind of cleared a spot here. And, the goal is to have that thing stripped down and, build a chassis cart for it within the next 2 days. So today's Monday. By tomorrow night, I want the car stripped, possibly the quarter panels cut off of it, and it put on a chassis cart. And then, if I stay on schedule with that, then, I can bring the drift truck in and start working on that as well too, because it's just been sitting in my garage taken apart because last year I was pretty hard on it. I think I had like 7 or 8 accidents or like touches, wall drags, taps on other people. So it's seen some shit, but it's just sitting in my garage all taken apart. It makes me sad looking at it. So I'd really like to get that thing in here this week and start fucking around with it. Also this week, I should be getting some 3D printed prototype bushings back for all this Cressida stuff. Subframe and knuckle bushings. I think I touched on that in the last video a little bit. But it'll be cool to have some 3D printed prototypes. And then I should be getting pricing information back from the machine shop on machining all the bushings and sleeves. And we'll go from there. So pretty stoked on that. It's the first time I've had it. No, that's a lie. It's not the first time I've had a 3D printed prototype of something. But nonetheless, I'm really excited about it. So yeah, I'm going to go up to the other unit, start kind of organizing up there and getting the E36 ready to pull out. So I'll update you guys once it's in here. All right, so the E36 is in. My friend Kyle's here. He helped me move it because, like I said, I can't move this thing by myself. He's going to start stripping stuff down in the front end, and I'm going to start working on interior stuff. First, we had to pull out all the parts that were inside of it. So there's kind of a lot. Just 2 years of hoarding shit, plus there's more tucked in the corner of this shop. So, I'll set up a time lapse and we're gonna just start thrashing on this fucking thing. progress on this thing. Kyle had to leave. He had to go to work. He works night shift. But, yeah, got most of the interior out. The glass is pulled. I'm just working on pulling all the stuff on the firewall, and then I'm going to pull the carpet. And then I'll move on to pulling stuff like the brake booster, the fuse relay panel, all the heater control stuff. And then after that, probably get it up in the air, start pulling fuel tank, brake lines, fuel lines, and heat shields and everything else. So getting close. Just going to keep on plugging away. Fuck, what a thrash. So Avery just left. It's like 9 o'clock now. But this thing's pretty much a bare naked shell. There's just little tiny bits here and there, some brake lines, clips, some trim, whatnot. But for the most part, we're there. So tomorrow I'm gonna come and clean up because the shop's a fucking disaster zone, and start building a cart for this thing. But I'm beat, and oh. You know, I should probably try and get this thing over the car wash across the street somehow and pressure wash this thing. Oh, I'll do that when it's on the cart. Duh. But yeah, I'm going to come back tomorrow, build the cart, get this thing elevated, get the shop clean, get this thing ready for fabrication, and we'll go from there. All right, next day, back at it. Kind of cleaning up some of the mess here. I got to strip down that rear subframe because the only thing I'm actually going to be keeping is the subframe itself. It's got some adjustable camber arms, but I got new PBM ones. I got PBM upper arms. And if I can't think of something else, I'm going to do M3 trailing arms because they have the bigger wheel bearing. So you get a bigger axle shaft in the hub, which is awesome. So basically that's all going away. This diff is going in the trash as well because I have a winner's quick change in that box right there. And I got new bushings for this, and that'll be that. So I also have to take the doors apart because I need the latches and the door handles because I have fiberglass doors that need to go on. I also need this half of the hinge, and then that'll be that. I'm gonna do M3 mirrors, so basically that's all gonna go in the trash too. The fenders were pretty wadded up on the bottom. Basically the only part that really matters because the E36 over fenders like actually bolt on the stock fender and covers up everything above the body line, but everything below the body line on those fenders is trash. So gotta do that. I'm probably gonna strip this front subframe too. I'm not gonna use that steering shaft that BMW uses with those rubber flex discs on them. I'm probably not gonna use these inner and outer tie rods either, so I basically just need the rack and the subframe itself. I might keep this sway bar. I know PBM sells a really nice front sway bar kit, or I might do like a Speedway Universal one with the blades off the end where you can bend them and adjust them and do all sorts of crazy stuff with those. And yeah, just trying to kind of sort through the keep pile and the trash pile. I originally was going to use this dash and make a composite one, basically use this as a plug for a mold. But Avery showed me, I never even knew it existed, but there's a non-airbag E36 dash, like 1994, maybe early 95, I don't know. But they look awesome, and he convinced me to try and find one of those instead if I'm going to go through all the effort of smoothing one and fiberglassing my own dash. So he's right, I'm going to do that. Other than that, I just got a couple little more things to pull off, like, you know, little brake lines, dangling wire stuff. Some lines and whatnot in here, and then I went to my metal supply place today and picked up a bunch of material. I was trying to get enough chromoly to do the cage in the E36 and the Miata, but they only had enough for really the Miata, so I'll have to wait to get the material for the E36. I also got the material to build the cart for the chassis. I bought the casters, and that's pretty much it. So got most of the shop cleaned up. I got the subframes all taken apart. Those are the old camber arms. I got a buddy of mine coming to pick those up in a little while. But yeah, just been cleaning up, kind of disassembling things and making sure that I'm keeping the stuff that I'm going to need so I'm not having to go to a junkyard and get it twice. But at this point, I think I'm ready to start building the cart. And my idea is in the back. I was originally thinking of grabbing it from here, but instead I think I'm going to grab it out here just so the cart's wider and it'll be less likely to tip over. So I'll grab it from one of these trailing arm bolts on either side, and then up here in the front I'll grab it from one of the front subframe bolts. So I have the material in the trailer. I'm going to go ahead and unload it and start measuring stuff and cutting it. And I think what I'm going to do for the attachment point on this is I'm actually going to take a section of tube and cut it probably in like a 6-inch section, cap the end and knock a hole in it. So then that way it's like a boss and the bolt will go up on the inside of it with an extension and then bolt to the car. Then I'll weld the side of that to the post for the chassis cart and gusset it and make sure it's all strong. And then, yeah, once I'm happy with that, I'll gusset all the legs to the base of the cart and put the casters on, and we should be done with that portion of it. I still haven't cut the quarter panels. My priority is to get this thing on a cart so I can get it out of here because I want to get the drift truck in tomorrow. But yeah, I took the doors apart, took all the stuff I needed out of the doors, which really wasn't much. Just the half of the hinge, the door handle, and the latch assembly. So who knows, maybe I'll have the time to slap the new doors on and see how those fit. But I'm going to get started on cutting out a cart for this thing. Okay, so I got a bit done on the cart, basically got all the uprights and I got the rear wheels tacked on here, but unfortunately I ran out of gas on the MIG welder. I keep a small bottle on the MIG welder because I hardly ever use it. I use the TIG pretty much on everything, but I'm not about to TIG weld this fucking cart that's going to end up in the trash once this car's done. So in the meantime, I worked on fitting up one of my fiberglass doors. Pretty stoked on it. It actually fits really well. Had to cut out the spot for the latch, and I'll have to cut out this little thing here so I can install the door handle. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with it. Like, closes really nice. This flange is on here, so I think you can mount a polycarbonate window if you want, but I'm not gonna do that, so I'm gonna cut this off. So that'll clean that up, and then get a nice set of M3 mirrors for it, and then put the door handles on, and yeah, I'm pretty stoked about it. So I kind of cleaned up a little bit more through kind of the parts that were laying around in the trunk of this thing. And yeah, I'm gonna go get another welding bottle in the morning and come back, finish this cart up, and hopefully get this car out of here. I need to get this up in the other unit. It's gonna be kind of too late in the week tomorrow by the time I'm done with this to get the drift truck in. So I think I'll just get back to the regularly scheduled stuff and keep working on the Copo and the Miata. So it'll be cool though. At least I got 3 days on this thing. Pretty happy with that. And yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying this. Alright, so just pulled up to the shop and my motherfucking truck is on fire. I don't know what the fuck's going on in there. Fucking stupid ass shit. Fucking running board lights. Yeah, it's straight up on fucking fire in there. Guess I should probably fix that. This one, the LZ fucking maximum drift cast. Shit. Fuck. All right, I gotta fix this. Okay, so not exactly the best start to my day. Had to run around and do a bunch of shit. Had an appointment for the baby, and had to go pick up a new welding tank and do a bunch of stuff with the wife, and then get here. My truck's on fire. So, yeah, this little fucking bulb was smoldering and melted through the plastic. Glad I noticed that and I had the door open, because fuck, who knows, the truck might have burnt down or something. But yeah, anyways, got a tank, so I'm gonna set this up and I'm gonna weld this fucking cart, weld the casters on it, put some gussets on it, probably just time lapse most of this, but yeah, I'm gonna get this thing on the ground in a little bit here. Alright, so I got the E36 on its cart here. All the parts for the car are in the car or on the cart. Got a lot of shit in here. Probably won't be using this dash and most of the dash parts, because like I said, Avery kind of convinced me to get a non-airbag dash. So I'm going to be looking for one of those. But yeah, looking at this thing, I probably should have tried to find some bigger casters. And this thing's really fucking top heavy. I almost tipped the car over putting it up here. But I hope you guys are enjoying the progress and the new videos. You know, the videos coming back to the channel. So This is going to be part one for this build. There's going to be, obviously, a shitload more. There's a lot of work ahead of me on this, but got to pay the bills, so got to work on customer cars, so this thing's back up here in the storage unit. And, yeah, thank you guys for watching. So stay tuned for more videos of this car, and it's going to be a lot of fun. But back to work on the customer stuff. See you guys next video. Bye.